Well, now, in the run-up to Christmas, Ashleigh Parker from Brighton is reminding young people about the benefits of friendship with older people and just how rewarding it can be to spend time with them.
Well, with the help of Fixers, the charity that gives young people a voice, Ashleigh has created a film that shows how the life experience of an older friend can help a young person and their anxieties. Here she is to tell us her story.
My name is Ashleigh Parker, I'm 25 and I'm from Brighton. My Fixers project is aimed at encouraging younger people to make friends with the older generation. Most of my friends, you know, as you'd expect, are in their 20s, but I also have friends who are a lot older than me.
Double word! Nice!
Wow!
We do completely different things, but they're still things that I really enjoy. When I was about 17 years old, my mum worked at a care home. I found I really enjoyed the company of older people. I now volunteer for the neighbourhood care scheme in Brighton, and I've been seeing various people over the years. I've made a film with Fixers, and the aim of the film was to show that you do actually have more in common than you think with an older person.
It took me months to pluck up the courage to ask Sarah out.
How did you even meet?
Isolation is one of the really significant things that impact on older people's mental health and make them feel quite low. It's really great that Ashleigh's sort of getting out there and encouraging younger people to befriend older adults. When they have somebody come to them and visit them, it definitely lifts their mood. It's a dual sort of thing. Both parties get a lot out of it.
I'm 92 this coming Christmas Day. If you're stuck indoors, isolated, then to have young people come in the door with all their youth and their vitality and their new ideas, it gives me a sense of self-worth that I'm worth somebody, some young people coming to see me.
Because there's such a massive age gap, people just don't think that they're going to have a lot in common with them. But the way I see it is that they were young once themselves, and they're going to have all this knowledge, and you know, they've been through different things that we have yet to go through ourselves, and they can offer you advice and they can be your friend.
I know you well enough.
It doesn't matter how old they are. When you talk to an elderly person, you realise how much they made the most of what they had, and they're so appreciative of it. It does make you kind of see things differently.
The elderly woman that I go and see is in her 90s. And go see her once a week, and we just end up chatting away for like 3 hours. And it's just really interesting to hear about someone who's grown up in a time that's like so different.
One big factor of it is that we use our phones so often, and them being someone that never really uses their phone, you kind of realise how valuable conversations are.
People older than you are used to them being in like positions of authority, so then it's nice to sort of talk to someone older than you like as if they're like your peer.
Okay. I know it sounds like such a cliche when people say, oh, well, you know, making somebody happy makes you happy, but when you can honestly look back on somebody's life and you can genuinely see the impact that you've actually made, that you've made their lives just that little bit better, it's such a good feeling to know that you've done that for somebody else, and that's what keeps me going back, and that's what's so beneficial. It makes you feel so good.
And as always, you can get more information on Fixers on their website, fixers.org.uk. Well, now, in the run-up to Christmas, Ashleigh Parker from Brighton is reminding young people about the benefits of friendships with older people and how rewarding it can be to spend time with them.
Yes, with the help of Fixers, the charity that gives young people a voice, Ashleigh has created a film that shows how the life experience of an older friend can help a young person and their anxieties. Here she is to tell us her story.
My name is Ashleigh Parker, I'm 25 and I'm from Brighton. My Fixers project is aimed at encouraging younger people to make friends with the older generation. Most of my friends, you know, as you'd expect, are in their 20s, but I also have friends who are a lot older than me.
Double word! Nice!
Wow!
We do completely different things, but they're still things that I really enjoy. When I was about 17 years old, my mum worked at a care home. I found I really enjoyed the company of older people. I now volunteer for the neighbourhood care scheme in Brighton, and I've been seeing various people over the years. I've made a film with Fixers, and the aim of the film was to show that you do actually have more in common than you think with an older person.
It took me months to pluck up the courage to ask Sarah out.
How did you even meet?
Isolation is one of the really significant things that impact on older people's mental health and make them feel quite low. It's really great that Ashleigh's sort of getting out there and encouraging younger people to befriend older adults. When they have somebody come to them and visit them, it definitely lifts their mood. It's a dual sort of thing. Both parties get a lot out of it.
I'm 92 this coming Christmas Day. If you're stuck indoors, isolated, then to have young people come in the door with all their youth and their vitality and their new ideas, it gives me a sense of self-worth that I'm worth somebody, some young people coming to see me.
Because there's such a massive age gap, people just don't think that they're going to have a lot in common with them. But the way I see it is that they were young once themselves and they're going to have all this knowledge and, you know, they've been through different things that we have yet to go through ourselves, and they can offer you advice and they can be your friend.
I know you well.
It doesn't matter how old they are. When you talk to an elderly person, you realise how much they made the most of what they had and they're so appreciative of it. It does make you kind of see things differently.
The elderly woman that I go and see is in her 90s. And go see her once a week, and we just end up chatting away for like 3 hours. And it's just really interesting to hear about someone who's grown up in a time that's like so different.
One big factor of it is that we use our phones so often, and them being someone that never really uses their phone, you kind of realise how valuable conversations are.
People older than you, you're used to them being in like positions of authority. So then it's nice to sort of talk to someone older than you, like as if they're like your peer.
I know it sounds like such a cliche when people say, oh, well, you know, making somebody happy makes you happy. But when you can honestly look back on somebody's life and you can genuinely see the impact that you've actually made, that you've made their lives just that little bit better, it's such a good feeling to know that you've done that for somebody else. And that's what keeps me going back, and that's what's so beneficial. It makes you feel so good.
What a good idea, and you can get more information on Fixers on their website, fixers.org.uk.